evening, everybody. I'm back with a very special episode of Talent Hunt. Tonight, we are in Kolkata. Of course, I'm in Kolkata, and my guest, he is as well. I met him for the first time last year when he came to US, and he came to US with a group. And I was lucky to meet him there in last year, October, during the festival time. And I was excited to see him because he is a newcomer, and but he has his own idea of playing the instrument. So I want to welcome Arnab with us. And thank you so much, Arnab, for being here with all my viewers around the globe.
Hello, Namaskar. How are you? I'm doing good. This is Arnab Bhattacharya, a solo player from Kolkata. When this lockdown started in the month of March, initial days, I was very confused. I never knew what is to be done and what are the things to be done. But later on, got used to it. And then I decided to use this lockdown in a much more positive way.
Right now, the situation we're going globally is we're all in our home, and we're always trying to do something very creative. And being a musician, being someone who is so creative, I'm going to come to the point little by little, but want to know more about your lockdown time and how you spent it and what you were doing that's new that you want to share with us.
In this lockdown, the first thing I did was I published my long pending album. So it got released. It's called Dark Inside. It's a world music collaboration with many musicians from around the world has collaborated, and the album was called The Dark Inside. So and it became very popular in many parts of the world. So I got an offer to make the second part of it, another album. So I started making this music, and then I found that the first track I was working on is almost around 15 to 16 minutes. So, and it was like a story. I was thinking of a story and I was making the music. And the music was going along with the story. So then I thought, okay, to give a visual effect behind it, because I have never done anything such like that previously. So I made the music a bit short. From 15 minutes, I cut short to around 8 minutes, and then I thought of making this as a short movie, a music movie, short story movie, and I thought of, okay, if I'm thinking like that, because I have no experience of direction, no experience of camera, I'm awful in camera, trust me, I don't know how to handle a camera. If you ask me to hold a camera for 1 minute, you will, and after that, if you get to see the recordings, you will see that the recording is like, it's like shaking a lot. So I don't know how to hold a camera. In fact, I don't know how to direct a person, that how to go about the shooting, because I've got no clue about it. So I thought, okay, let's not get into it. So I thought, okay, let's think in a different way. Then I thought of making things like to make the movie with a still photography. So I spoke to many, many photographers from around the globe who are my friends and friends of friends. So they said that, okay, for this 8-minute story that I've made, the music that I've made actually, at least around odd 3,000 to more than 3,000 photography things we need actually. And after that, we need to create the sequence, because there was something like there was a terrorist attack and there was, you know, something like that. So we have to create the sequence and then we have to shoot it. It was difficult. So the still photography, the plan was cancelled. Then I thought, okay, I'll make an animation of it. Then I thought, okay, animation is something which is very old concept. Okay. Then it came into my mind, I met a person. Then I thought of going through graphics noveling. Graphics noveling is something like it's a still graphics pictures, and after that you make motion out of it. Motion in the sense with using the lights and everything, not with the picture, but with using the lights and many other things. It's called the graphics noveling. So you feel as if the picture is talking. So I met a guy whose name is Ronak. He did a splendid job, and we were in the lockdown in Calcutta. So we had to communicate everything over the phone. In fact, trust me, nobody will believe. After getting this so many awards and rewards for this film, till date we have not yet met. Me, my graphics person, and my video editor, we have not yet met in this lockdown period, but the entire thing happened. So then he started doing this graphics part, and there's another person, Deepan, who was taking care of my video editing, and we did it, and it's called The Life After Death. It's the entire story. I have named it Life After Death because I thought this is a phase in our life where we all are going through some negative, negative energy all around, negative vibes all around. At least at this point of time, we are now a bit relaxed because we are used to this situation right now. But I'm talking about 2 months back, we were all very depressed. We're already frustrated. We have no clue what is happening. So there was always a negative energy around us, and so I thought, okay, let's make something, the music like that, because music is something like an inner voice. What you think inside, it comes out. Okay, so this is the best way of expression, you know. So so I made the music such like that, that had a ray of hope after devastating life or journey. This is how it's called, The Life After Death. And this Ronak made this graphics thing, and Deepan made this video editing and everything. And I never ever thought that it is going to be such a well acclaimed all over the world. And then one of my film person, he's my very close friend of mine, he suggested, why don't you give it for some short film festival? Like, prior to that, I had never got any clue that this kind of short film festival happens around the world. Then I got in touch with many short film festival people and many film festivals. And there was no other category for this graphics or the animated. There was a category for animated movie, but there was no movie category for graphics movie. So I sent them the movie, and they really liked it. Some of them really liked it and got some award from Poland as a best music award, best sequence award. Many, I believe there were 6 to 7 awards I received from Poland, Sweden, Belgium, Belgium for Short Film Festival, Amsterdam Short Film Festivals, and so many other reviews. And within 3 or 4 days of the release, it almost touched the around 20-25,000 on the YouTube views, which was incredible. I never expected that. So this is how it's happening, and I'm hopeful that something or the other will come out in future again like this.
Idol motivation. We can say that we need somebody to show us the path, maybe in future, that we all take it seriously later on. So we want to know about your guru and how you started and how was it, and mostly why don't you play something as well for my viewers?
I started learning at the age of 4.5 from my father, Sri Swapan Kumar Bhattacharya. He was actually under the tutelage of Pandit Radhika Mohan Maitro. And he was a sarod player, but not professionally. He was a banker majorly. So, but sarod or the music was his passion. Okay. So when I grew up at the age of 4.5, I saw him practicing in the morning. So which actually I felt very nice and motivated. Like you wake up early in the morning at around 6 o'clock, and you see your father playing an instrument, and which is very melodious. Then in our times, on the television, some serials or some like Ramayana and Mahabharata used to were there actually. So, and I was not a very very polite or a very cool and calm guy. I was very naughty, what they used to say at that point of time. So my father took me to his guru at that point of time, Pandit Buddhadev Das Gupta. So I went there, and He the first day was very shocking because I was at the age of 4 and a half, and he was at his height was 6 foot 4 inches with a build up body. So I was a bit scared. So that was the first day, I believe, I got introduced to the instrument as well as the with a as a as a musician. I got exposed to see my guru in front. So then it started. I got a very small sarod. My father made me a very small sarod, and I started getting the training under him, my own father. And I was getting trained, and after a year of training for some advanced, I was playing a bit well at that point of time. And then my father took me to his Guruji at that point, Pandit Buddhadev Das Gupta, and I started taking the advanced training until started from that particular day till date. I'm still learning under his tutelage, and in the meantime, because of my Guruji, I went to other musicians to get some training from them and get some valuable suggestions from them. So this is how it works, and in a classical music it works in that way. So starting from 4 and a half, and then I never thought that I'd be a musician. I always wanted to be a footballer. I always wanted to be into the sports. So because as a Bengali guy, you know, everyone is a footballer. All the Bengali guys are footballer. So even I thought of being a footballer. So after passing my engineering, after I completed my engineering, as a Bengali guy, you always look after security, because I was the first generation of musician. So I went to a job. I was doing good, but there was something was happening that I was feeling that this job is not my cup of tea. I was looking for music. I started feeling that I'm doing some injustice to my music, because what happens is when you start getting trained from 4 and a half years old, this sarod or this music was never an extracurricular activities in my life. It was in my routine, the way you used to wake up in the morning and used to get freshen up. So in the same way we need to practice, it was always a part of my life, part of my routine day life. So we never thought it as at least I never thought it as a extracurricular activities in my life. During this job period, when I was doing this job, I was a software engineer. So I was doing this job. I felt that somewhere I was not able to practice for a long time, you know. So I felt that I am doing some injustice to my music, which I was not feeling good at all. So then one fine day I thought of, okay, let's quit this job and let's be a musician whole time or the full time or the professional musician. It was tough. Initial days, it was very, very tough, I must say. I was in Delhi, and I left my job, and there was no concerts in my hand. So I have got no clue how to move forward. And so it was initial days was tough, but you know, with all the support of everybody, like my wife, she was not my wife at that point of time, she was my girlfriend, but she supported my father, my mom, my family, and the family supported a lot. And yeah, fortunately it happened. And another guy was there, I need to mention, his name was Dominic Joseph. He was a guy, he's a brilliant guitarist, he's in New York. So he supported me a lot musically. He was the person who showed this world music scenario in front of me. So this is how it started, and still going on. Still I'm learning. I'm collaborating with many musicians around the globe, coming up with some new projects, and getting trained in all kind of music, listening to all music and getting trained from them. And this is how it's moving.
Music, we all love. That is so much close to our souls, and this time, in this time, like globally, we all are trying to do something creative, isn't it? My next question to you will be that: how music and this world is connecting globally, and what you think about it?
Music and this world, yeah, I do believe that music is globalizing because. It is not, music was always global, because if you go back to the history, there was a famous person whose name was Amir Khusru. he came from Persia to India, and that is around, I believe, in 12th century he came. He was a Sufi musician. So he came from Persia to India, and then in India there were only three kinds of music was there. Those are Drupad, Haveli Sangeet, and Prabandh Gayaki. These were the three primary music that was there in India. Drupad, Prabandh music, and Haveli Sangeet. So when this person, Amir Khusro, came to India, he was a stalwart of two form of music, which is called Kal and Kalbana, which nowadays we call it as Qawwali. So he came to India and he started roaming around the around this country, and he started, you know, blending the all the Sufi form of music and this form of music, which later on became khayal. From there we get all this kind of, he went to this folk music, he started blending the folk musics, and it became Dadra, Chaiti, Kajri. So the music was always globalizing, it was always evolving. It was then this, you know, the Pandit Ravi Shankar went abroad. Nobody could believe that Pandit Ravi Shankar is being an Indian classical musician, like with just a sitar, a tanpura, and a tabla, a person can fit into the stage of Woodstock. He played in the Woodstock and the people got crazy. So this is, I believe this is one of the examples of globalizing the music. In the same way, there are so many folk artists, rock music, pop music, jazz music. They came to India and they started. There were a prolific one. Jazz musician was there in India. It's called Carlton Kito. He was there in Calcutta. So he was a prolific jazz musician. So the music was always globalized, you know. Pandit Ravi Shankar went, then Ali Bakr Khan Sahab, Ustad Zakir Hussain, Shiv Kumar Sharma Ji, and the major, another reason of this globalization is all the musicians, what irrespective of, you know, the place, color, caste, anything, religion, all the musicians always started collaborating. They always collaborated with each other, you know. If you see Zubin Mehta's orchestra, the symphony, you will find Pandit Ravi Shankar performing there along with he performed with Yudhi Menahai. So this is how it was always, the collaboration was always there, which was actually helping the music to reach globally. This is how it's working. And that's why you, in our Bollywood music, in our film music, you will find a lot of influence of Western music in there. In the same way, in the Western part, like in many film music, you will find some Indian form of music is incorporated into their films and everywhere. So in the songs and in the writings, and then for example, violin is a Western instrument. Now it is treated as an Indian classical instrument, one of the primary Indian classical instrument. For example, harmonium, it's a Western, it came from piano, so it started like that. Accordion, now in saxophone, Indian classical was played. And in the same way, in sitar, portion of jazz or blues is being played. In sarod, jazz and blues. I myself play the jazz in my sarod. So jazz and blues are played in sarod. In flute, in bamboo flute, this blues and jazz is being played. Rock music has been played, and people have started collaborating. Fusion was already happening from ages. Now we have put this, the sound system, amplifiers, and so many other things, just to, you know, make the sound big, more clear, crystal clear, and technically more, you know, advanced, to make this global music more soothing and in a broad way. So music was, and will be global forever, actually.
We are talking about music, we are talking about you as a musician, but I want to go a little further. I just want to go away, or I can say the drift a little bit, because I saw something in YouTube and it really attracted me. You are a director, Well, yes, my friends, he's a director and he just directed a short film. And also that film is a little different. Let me show you guys a little glimpse of it. And then we want to know from Arnab that how he was like what he did and what was going on in his mind when he first thought that he want to make a short film.
Hello. Hey, hi. Yeah, yeah. Tell me. Okay. Okay. Anything serious? No. What's the issue? Anything urgent? Let me check. Okay. Let me check and I'll get back to you. Let me check. Hello, Victor. Hi. Can you just check for the next flight to Kolkata, because I need to go there urgently. Not pretty sure. Got a call from my home and they're asking me to be there as soon as possible, sir. Okay, great. Okay, waiting for your call. Thank you. Thank you so much.
Seat. Pull the mask out of the clip. Then pull the mask to your face, placing it over your nose and mouth and securing it with the elastic.
I see trees of green, red roses too. I see them bloom for me and you. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world. I see skies of blue and clouds of white, the bright blessed day, the dark sacred night, and I think to myself, what a wonderful world.
We want to hear you more, Arnab, but the thing is that we have to leave, and I can say that it was great meeting you then in October and right now as well. Friends, you are watching a very special episode of Talent Hunt in this lockdown session, and that is Rock and Ball. And tonight it was rocking with Arnab. Thank you so much for being there with us. And my viewers, next Monday, please do not forget to watch your favorite show and catch me with somebody globally around us with your favorite show Talent Hunt in Manativ International. Till then, please stay safe, stay well, and I want that whatever you wish for, it comes true, and this whole year should be a blessing for all of us. Thank you so much and good night.